Joseph friends. My name is Dia.
My name is Hannah.
My name is Lee.
And today we are going to be reading to you an original story written by us. It is called
The Adventures of Turtles in Water Pollution or Sewage.
Not long ago in a deep blue sea, there lived a contented turtle couple named Turtle Pa and Turtle Ma at the edge of the reef. The water was crystal clear and the seaweed swayed gracefully. The bright and colorful corals will make you want to explore deeper with these magnificent creatures. The gorgeous jellyfishes were light up the night. They were dancing to the seaweed's movement with the soft rings of the bells from a few sunken and abandoned ships. The neon shadows would light up and dance the symphony. The moonlight would shine onto the surface of the calm water, allowing the creatures to be visible at night. The performance would be a stunning painting. The dancers, light, and creatures would be the paintbrushes. Every movement that happened would brush against the black canvas. The scenario was slow and peaceful. Any audience's eyes would light up the skies in the fourth movement.
One day, out of the blue, Turtle Ma felt something in her stomach. Maybe you are ready to deliver the kids. Turtle Pa nodded wisely. They swam to shore. Turtle Ma swimming with full energy and determination for the sake of her dear eggs. After reaching the shore, Pa, drenched in sweat, started to dig a hole in the soft white sand with all his might. After a few minutes of digging, Turtle Ma hurriedly went over it and started to lay her eggs. Time went slowly for the couple. Finally, after months of waiting and nervousness, the eggs started to crack and hatch. It was so strange and so new to the couple, but to their dismay, only two baby turtles survived to make it back to the waters. Turtle Pa and Turtle Ma called them Lisa and Louis. They were not twins. Oh no, Lisa was older by a few months than Louis.
Months passed. It was a normal day, a supposedly normal day, when the sea turned into pure blackness. The unusual change frightened every living creature in the ocean. Dark shadows had appeared back and forth, darting here and there. But this one was very different. A ship had stopped on top of the coral maze, followed by a black substance pouring out of the huge ship. The precious juvenile, Louis, cried immediately after being blinded by blackness. Pa? Ma? Lisa? Louis's older sister was closest to him and heard his cry, and she swam towards the helpless cries from her little brother to save him before any more of the blackness could reach his eyes. The turtles swam a few miles away, racing as far as they could from the poison while ducking from trash and avoiding the strong waves and currents. They were finally able to reunite with their parents on shore. What happened? Lisa asked in panic as they saw the blackness slowly spread into the deeper parts of the water.
It was not a great sight for the turtles. The humans on the ship laughed and constantly chatted, making it seem like the blackness was harmless and that they had done nothing wrong. They were quite pleased by what they were doing. Ink! The humans have returned once more, Turtle Pa said in a deep voice. They have come in again, the humans. Turtle Ma cried in despair. Her newly grown seaweed and plant would be destroyed. Lisa felt helpless. Ma had only just finished sowing the plants, but now they would be cruelly wiped out.
The bodies of the residents who once lived in the same deep blue sea as the turtles began floating to the surface. Cries of help echoed through the seas, but the turtles could not risk going back into the black water. Even the tiniest bit of that toxic sludge could kill.
Why are they doing this? We have never destroyed their community. Lisa wondered helplessly.
Where will we live now? The last time they had attacked our home with trash, we had to move here. But now it's being invaded again.
Lewis's shoulders stooped as his head hung low. He had lost all of his hope and positivity.
The next day, the four turtles woke up to find three men looking down at them. Lisa was frightened. The past experiences she had with the humans were not good at all. We do not mean any harm to you. We are here to rescue you, one of the men said soothingly. The rest nodded their heads sincerely. Turtle Pa, Turtle Ma, and Lewis seemed to trust them, so Lisa did too. They allowed the men to place them in their van and drive them into somewhere. A new hope, or the opposite. After a few hours, Lewis was jolted awake by the loud sound of the moving men as they moved his family members into a huge lake. The place looked like their original habitat, but a little smaller.
Months passed, but Lewis was still very frightened about the changes to him. How he moved from a vast ocean to a lake, hunting for food to be given food every day, and most of all, going from a juvenile to an adult.
I'm finally an adult, Lewis cried in joy. A young adult, Turtle Ma corrected. The fact that you're a young adult doesn't mean that you don't have to eat your mom's cooking, Turtle Ma added as she pushed his plate of carrots towards him. Aw, come on, Lewis whined.
It was a long time since Turtle Ma was able to cook. She had snuck into the kitchen and stolen some carrots to make famous homemade carrot crunches. The family laughed joyously. They had definitely fit into the new home perfectly. A few months passed, and Turtle Ma had laid more eggs on the beach. Lewis was very excited, but he was finally not going to be the youngest, and now had someone to boss around. Turtle Ma buried the eggs to keep them safe from predators. Every week, the family would visit the eggs to see if they had grown into any hatchlings.
Two months passed. Look, Pa, Ma, little Lin has grown into a hatchling, Lewis cried. Lin had a dark green shell, so it was very easy to recognize her. Lin was brought back home to live with her family. She was a very curious and adventurous hatchling. He would find her in unusual places, enjoying herself. Lewis was quite disappointed that Lin was hard to boss around, and it was not easy to trick little Lin.
After a couple of months, five other hatchlings managed to join the family. They were Laura, Lucy, Linda, Lenny, and Lawrence. Finally, I have a baby brother to play with, and both our names rhyme, Lewis and Lawrence. Lewis chuckled, not to mention that I also have four other younger siblings to boss around. The family lived happily in peace, hoping that something like their disastrous past would not happen again to the five little hatchlings.
Which school values have you learned from this story?
Harmony.
Why harmony? Let's try someone else.
Respect.
Okay. managed to escape from the Oz village. There's one more. Anyone else knows the answer?
Thank you.